Beatbox.
Here's one I've been practicing. Boots and cats and boots and cats and boots and cats and boots and cats and boots. I could do this all day.
So first of all, I'm sorry for not posting for 2 weeks. I had exams, but finally I can come back to YouTubing and I'm happy. Right now you might be choosing a university and Bangor University might even be your first choice. But as I am very good at finding negatives, today we'll go through a list of the three reasons why Bangor University might not be for you. But let's do the vlog part of the video first. Finally got my dad's Christmas present. Danish peyote, Danish kirsebär sauce for the Danish Rieslingwand dessert. My favorite tea made with quince. More Danish cookies. My favorite wok. More Danish cookies. Vanilla. The rice for Rieslemang. So literally, I can actually make Rieslemang right now. More quilty. And I asked my dad to send me one Danish book on Danish history because I'm a little bit ashamed of me not knowing anything about Denmark. So he sent me this. The Queens and Women in the Danish History. More books on Danish history. Danish kings and queens. Dagmar, the princess of Denmark, the empress of Russia. Alexandra, the princess of Denmark, the queen of England. A book about the Danish military during the World War. This used to be one of my favorite series when I was a child. It's called Matador. And it's also about Danish history, but everyday Danish history among normal Danish people, not queens and kings. Here it is. A family book on Danish history and another history book on the end of the Second World War in the world from the Danish perspective. This was the box and I've received a ton of food. My favorite tea, which is weird. Denmark doesn't normally produce tea. I would expect countries such as, I don't know, India or China producing tea, but Denmark is the only place where I could find Kvill tea, which is my favorite tea. If you literally translate it, it's, come on, focus. It's quince tea. Lots of gingerbread cookies and a ton of books. But I would say that I expect this one and probably this one about the Second World War to be my favorites. And the family book, of course. To be honest, I feel like this video is more relevant for international students who don't really have the opportunity of traveling to the UK for an open day in Bangor University, but here we go. The first reason is obviously the hills. If you look over here, so this is the UK, and Bangor is this blue dot. If you look from above, it looks very nice, and I agree. But what you don't know, if you click on the 3D button, you can see that, kind of see, that Bangor is actually a valley in between two hills, which makes it a pain to walk from one side to another. And I've asked some people around here what they think about it.
Right. It is the worst hill I've ever walked up in my life.
It's quite a hill. It helps me not exercise. This is my excuse to say I'm exercising.
Okay, I just came. I'm a bit out of breath from walking up the hill. It's such a pain. I think my legs got bigger with all the muscles that formed from walking up and down this hill.
You know, I like this hill. Because of this hill, I never have to do leg day.
It's exhausting.
So if walking up and down hills is not for you, you might reconsider your choice, I guess. The second reason is obviously the weather. I knew that I would run into pretty windy situations here in Bangor when I arrived, but I did not expect there to be no snow. I moved from Moscow in Denmark to here, and both in Moscow and in Copenhagen there was snow. I moved here, it is January, and look what it looks like right now. Besides, when it's cold in Moscow, in Russia, it's very different from the cold here. When it's cold in Moscow, you can wear a few more layers of clothes and you'll be fine. If it's semi-cold here, it's actually really cold because the wind is so strong that it blows through any amount of layer of clothes. Also, it rains all the time here. Just a side note. The third, and probably the main reason for me disliking Bangor somewhat, is the shagginess of Bangor. If you walk around High Street, which is one of the main shopping streets in Bangor, you'll see faded signs for shops, you'll see doors that are crooked, you'll see buildings that are falling apart, you'll see rusty windows, and none of this is very pleasant to look at. But as soon as you turn down a road from High Street, for example, you will see a lot of litter around everywhere. Anywhere you go, there is going to be a plastic bottle laying there, and a mitten over there, and a fork over there, and it is not pleasant to look at. I strongly dislike it. So these are the three things that put me off the most. I will be publishing a video later on that will describe the main reasons why you should come to Bangor, because there is a lot of reasons why you should, obviously for university reasons and other stuffs, but it requires a lot more filming, and this was just a quick video after the long period of the 2 weeks that I haven't filmed. So thank you very much for watching, and I really, really, really appreciate it. It means a lot to me as a beginner YouTuber. Thank you. Thank you.